By the power of Grayskull, I have the power! Well, that's some bullshit. Hey everybody, it's Benny One, and I'm back at you with another review, and today I finally finished watching Masters of the Universe Revelation, everybody, the new He-Man series that's on Netflix. Part one is out right now. It's 5 episodes, and then they're doing part two. I don't think they have a date yet for part two, but so I'm going to start off by saying that obviously I was born in 1987, so I was not alive yet when the He-Man toys, because the original He-Man cartoon show was literally based off of the toys that they came up with and created, the He-Man toys, He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. So, like, naturally, they basically were like, well, we gotta have a cartoon show, because most toy lines get a cartoon show. And it became huge, like, huge, 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 huge. But I do remember watching He-Man when I was a kid, reruns on TV, so I am a He-Man fan. I'm not going to sit here and say that I'm like a die-hard He-Man fan. Like, these are the reproduction toys. These are not the original toys. So, I'm not a die-hard He-Man fan. I like He-Man. I love the original He-Man cartoon. Like, I do. I love it. I just want people to know that before I start talking about this, because this show is very controversial. The fans are pissed off about this show because of what they chose to do with the story and the characters and the lore, all sorts of stuff. I've read people's comments about it, everything. People are pissed off about this show. I'm not one of them. I am not one of those people that is really mad about what they chose to do with it. I actually kind of like what they did with it. And that might be because I'm not a die-hard He-Man fan that grew up with He-Man, like when it was coming out. That might be why I feel that way. So, Kevin Smith, I love Kevin Smith. And people, man, people are trashing him on the internet about this. They are, like, trashing him. They're saying his career's over, everything. He's a writer and a executive producer for this new He-Man series on Netflix. So, pretty big deal for him, honestly, because, you know, he's done Clerks, Mallrats and stuff, and, you know, Jay and Silent Bob, Jay and Strike Back, Jay and Silent Bob Reboot, Clerks 2, you know, Silent Bob, you know, it's Kevin Smith. I love Kevin Smith. He's a big comic book nerd that smokes weed. I love Kevin Smith. He's a cool guy. But yeah, the internet is trashing the shit out of Kevin Smith about this show. So, and you know what, though? This show is fantastic. It looks great. The voice cast is fantastic. It's awesome. The ensemble they got to do the voice cast for this TV show is crazy. I'm going to go down a list and name off most of them. Not all of them, but they got a crazy voice cast for this show. Like, seriously. It looks awesome. Looks beautiful. The artwork, the design, everything is great. And it brought He-Man from the 80s, and they updated it. They gave it a modern update. And I thought they did a fantastic job with all of that. So, Chris Wood plays He-Man. I think he's the guy that was in Supergirl, I think, maybe? I'm not sure. The TV show? I can't remember. Mark Hamill, everybody. Everybody knows who Mark Hamill is. He does Skeletor. He does a freaking great job voicing Skeletor. Sarah Michelle Gellar plays Teela. And that's one thing that people are pissed about with this show is what they did. They basically, Teela is a really big part of this story in part one in the show. I'm going to try and keep this as spoiler free as I can in case anybody hasn't seen it yet. It's been out for almost a month now, so if I say something that spoils it, I'm sorry. Go watch it. It's been out for a while now. It took me too long to finish it. So, yeah, Sarah Michelle Gellar plays Teela, and I think she does a fantastic job. I can't picture her voicing a character like this, but I thought she did good work. Lena Headey, she was in the Terminator TV show back on Fox years ago, and then she was in Game of Thrones. She plays freaking Evelyn, and she's great as Evelyn, like perfect voice casting choice for Evelyn. Harley Quinn Smith, Kevin Smith's daughter, plays Lena. She's in this. I love that he named his daughter Harley Quinn also. I just think that's badass. Alicia Silverstone, everybody, plays Queen Melina. Just Alicia Silverstone. Who would have thought? She plays Queen Melina. Kevin effing Conroy, everybody. That's right. Batman himself plays Merman. I did not know he was in this. I did not know until I looked up the list of people. I did not know. Phil Lamar plays Hero. He's the guy that did the voice for Jon Stewart and obviously other animated characters over the years, but I most know him as Jon Stewart, the Green Lantern, in the Justice League animated shows and Justice League Unlimited. So Justin Long plays Roboto. Everyone, Justin Long. Everybody knows who Justin Long is. Henry Rollins, he's a familiar guy. He plays Triclops. Let's see who else we got. Jason Mewes, Kevin Smith's good buddy, plays, he's Jay and Jay and Silent Bob. He plays Stinkor, which is a perfect character for him to play. And then Tony Todd, he plays Scareglow, which is kind of like Skeletor, but he's down in, like, hell, basically. So he was the original Candyman, which is pretty cool. And Griffin Newman plays Orko, everybody. And there's more cast. I didn't name off every single person, but fantastic voice cast. Like, seriously, fantastic. They picked a great group of people, and I think they all did a good job. So, yes, here we go. The show starts off just like Kevin Smith said it would. The first episode, you get your traditional He-Man type episode that was in the classic He-Man show. You get the fight between Skeletor and He-Man trying to take Grayskull, the classic thing that always happened in the original show. You get that in this modern, updated version. Woo! It's really cool. The first episode was awesome. It most definitely took me back, for sure. And they do a fantastic job of telling the story in a way so that people that are new can understand what's going on and kind of get where these characters are, because it's a continuation of the He-Man animated series. So it's a continuation of what came before, even though it's a new show. And they shake shit up. They do shake shit up. But the first episode, it's nostalgic. Completely nostalgic. When he transforms into He-Man,
by the power of Grayskull, I have the power!
When Adam transforms into He-Man for the first time in this first episode, it gave me goosebumps. It looked so awesome, really cool. The fights were awesome. It was fantastic. I was hooked right off the first episode. But then the first episode ends, and I already could tell that what I was reading about people being pissed, I could get why they're mad. Because they shake shit up. They really do. They shake things up. They put our characters in different situations than what you would be used to. Some characters are gone. Some are in completely different places. Because the first episode happens. And then when the second episode picks up, I'm not sure how much time went by. But some time did go by, more than just a couple months, and things are different in Eternia. They're completely different. It's crazy, but I like it. I like the changes that they went with, because we got to see characters team up with other characters that you wouldn't even think of. And like Orko, and like, actually, he's still that funny character in this, but they actually give him an adult story, a meaningful story for his character. Just like Griffin, like, they give him, who's been a big joke as a character until he transforms with He-Man, like, they give him a meaningful story arc in this. And that's the thing for me as a kid watching He-Man reruns growing up. I feel like this is an adult continuation of that show. And that's the thing is they wanted to take this great character, all these characters from He-Man, and they wanted to give a... Because we're all adults now. The people that grew up watching He-Man when it was airing, like, we're all adults now. And they gave us that nostalgia right off the bat. But then they shake it up a lot. Like, they really shake shit up. They do. It's crazy what they do. I'm not going to sit here and tell you it's not. And I understand why the people are mad. I do. I get it. But I like what they did with it. I really do. And it's adult. It's just an adult version of these characters. And by the time it's over with, they kind of bring shit back to what you're used to. But then, man, cliffhanger. Cliffhanger when episode 5 ends. Holy shit, I'm like, when is part 2 coming out? Because I want part 2 right now, because it ended on a cliffhanger, and it is a big ass cliffhanger. There is something that happens to a couple of characters in the show at the end of episode 5 that made my jaw drop and made me go, oh my god, are you serious? Like, this is happening right now? Like, I can't wait for part 2. So, guys, like I said, I'm not going to dive into spoilers. I could have spoiled the shit out of what happened in this first part of it. I honestly feel like people are being a little too harsh on this. I get it. It's not the He-Man that you grew up with. I do. I get that it's not the He-Man that people grew up with. It's different. It is. But it's a great cartoon series. Like, animated He-Man show. It's great. Like, it was written well. The voice acting was great. The artwork and everything is fantastic. The music, everything about it is awesome. Like, I'll put a thing up about Rotten Tomatoes and shit. Like, Rotten Tomatoes has it, like, it's at like 95% or something, but the fan score is down like in the low 20s. It is crazy, the divisiveness that this show is doing. But I thought it was awesome. I thought it was entertaining. So I'm going to give the first season, or part 1 or whatever, of Masters of the Universe Revelation, I'm going to give it a freaking 8 out of 10. I enjoyed it. I really did. I enjoyed it. I thought it was good. I don't think it's perfect, obviously, because there are things that happened in it and certain characters I would have liked to see more in it. But what they did with what they were going with, I thought it was great. So I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10, everybody. I hope you guys enjoyed that review. Thanks for watching. And I'll be catching you on the tube later, because I have spoken.